2 years ago, the entire scientific community, including us, freaked out because researchers discovered flowing liquid water on the surface of Mars. But now some scientists aren't so sure. According to a paper published on Monday in Nature Geoscience, it might just be sand, which is way less fun. You know, sand is coarse and rough and gets everywhere. Since life on Earth relies on liquid water, we're always searching for it in other parts of the solar system in case maybe it contains alien bacteria or can teach us more about our planet. And thanks to previous missions, we've found that on Mars there's plenty of water frozen in polar ice caps or floating around as water vapor. But in 2015, researchers announced that they'd found liquid water trickling down hills on Mars's surface. Specifically, they found hydrated salts, which are just salt molecules attached to some water molecules, and these hydrated salts created dark, flowing lines on Mars's surface called recurring slope lineae, or RSLs. On the off chance that life was hanging out in those RSLs, we didn't want to send the Curiosity rover to check them out because it's contaminated with material from Earth, but scientists have been analyzing them with satellites. In this new paper, they used the high-rise satellite orbiting Mars to study the slopes of more than 150 RSLs at 10 different sites. They found that, on average, almost all of the RSLs ended when a hill got between 28 and 35 degrees steep. And according to measurements of Martian sand dunes, that's about the same angle where flowing sand stops moving. The scientists here argue that if the RSLs do contain liquid water, some of them should flow past that roughly 30 degree mark. Still, that's not the only reason they're questioning the liquid water idea. For one, if RSLs were filled with salty water, they should be depositing dry salt piles when the water eventually evaporates, but scientists haven't found any yet. Also, one of the arguments for RSLs containing water is that they appear seasonally, like water is freezing and then melting. But this team observed that sand flows can also change seasonally based on how dust blows around Mars's surface. Still, this definitely isn't a perfect hypothesis. The researchers admitted that seasonal sand flow happens more easily on certain dunes that are constantly replenished by new sand blowing onto them, and the hills where we've seen RSLs aren't all like that. And sand can't explain the hydrated salts either, but there are other possibilities. Previous studies, like one published last year in Geophysical Research Letters, have suggested that they could be caused by carbon dioxide frost instead, which would form when gas condenses and freezes on the surface. So before you throw your swimsuit into your bag, put it on your Mars rocket, maybe wait a little while before we know a little more. But don't abandon your suitcase entirely, because last week astronomers announced that they'd found a new nearby exoplanet that might be one of the most welcoming yet. It's called Ross 128b, and it was spotted using HARPS, an instrument attached to a telescope in Chile. HARPS is one of our most successful tools for finding new worlds. It discovers planets by measuring wobbles in stars, which suggests that something, like a planet, is pulling on them. And that's how we found 128b. This new planet orbits a red dwarf star only 11 light years away, making it the second closest Earth-like exoplanet we've found. Proxima Centauri b is just about 4 light years away. Red dwarfs are the most common stars in the universe, and they can be great exoplanet parents. They're only half the size of the sun at most and aren't too bright or hot. And while some of them can give off the occasional violent burst of radiation, the star 128b orbit seems especially calm. From what we know so far, Ross 128b doesn't seem too different from Earth. It's about the same size, and its temperature probably ranges from around negative 60 to 20 degrees Celsius. But since its star is so small, 128b orbits it a lot more closely than we do to the sun, around 20 times closer. This helps it stay nice and warm, but it also means a year there lasts a little less than 10 days. But if you don't mind, you know, a lot of birthday cake, that's not bad. Right now, even though the planet seems homey, we're not sure what its atmosphere is like or if it has liquid water on its surface, so that's the next thing to figure out. But when the European Southern Observatory's extremely large telescope comes online in 2024, it should be able to figure out if 128b has any oxygen in its atmosphere. For now, it's still the most temperate planet we've ever found around such a calm star, so that's still pretty awesome. And we'll be learning more about it soon. Plus, 128b's star is currently cruising toward our solar system, and in around 70,000 years, it will be the closest star to the Earth besides the sun. So if we're still around in 70,000 years, but still haven't got like warp drive figured out, at least the trip will be a little shorter if we do decide to go. All right, exciting announcement. I've been telling everybody about this. The SciShow team and I were talking about a problem that many of us have. Often, people will ask us what we want for Christmas or for our birthdays, and we won't know what to say because we don't care about stuff that much. But then I was thinking, there are things that I would like to get or that I've bought for myself or that people have given to me that I really love because I love the world, I love the universe, like the existence of biology, that kind of thing. So we put together a collection of artifacts of this universe. We got a limited number of each of those things and we have put them up at a store called SciShow Finds. The SciShow Finds are curated by me. They are things that I would love to get in my stocking. It's a very small list of just 6 cool things of varying price points. I did my best to only include one science book. It's the book that I read this year that affected me the most. It's called What is Life? And it makes an extremely compelling case that biology is a chemical inevitability, which is a really important thought for having there be life out there in the universe. As time progresses, we're probably going to add some new finds, and as we add new ones, they will replace the old ones, so all these products are only around for a limited time. You're bound to have friends or family who would love, like, some Mars socks or trilobite fossils, maybe the space shuttle lapel pin, and if not, you might just want to get them for yourself. Or, like, slide the link in if anybody's like, what do you want, man? Just be like, zoom, scishowfinds.com. And know that when you go to scishowfinds.com or send somebody there, you're also supporting SciShow, so thank you. Thank you for doing that in that way, and also for doing that by watching this video. You're the best.